Hello everyone, welcome to part 2 of jQuery. And in the first part we have seen the introduction to jQuery, we have seen the syntax of the jQuery, we have seen that why we are using the jQuery and why jQuery is better than JavaScript. Okay, so let's see the syntax of jQuery once again. Here is the syntax, that is the dollar, selector and then action. So in this video we are going to cover the basic selector of jQuery, that is I'm going to tell you the basic selector, that is element, ID and class. So we are going to learn these three selectors in this video: element, ID and class selectors. These are the three basic selectors of jQuery that everyone must know. Okay, so see the selector. So selector itself means like we are selecting some kind of element we are going to select. Okay, selector itself like the name suggest, selector, you are selecting something. Okay, so here we are going to select some HTML element. Okay, we are going to select some HTML element to perform some kind of action on other HTML elements, or to change the other HTML elements, to change the CSS of other HTML elements, to change the text of other HTML elements. I mean, anything you can do. Okay, so like last time what we have done, if you will see, last time we have done on the click of the button, we are hiding the div, means this thing we are doing. See on the click of button element, see on the click of button element we are hiding the div element. See, now it is more clear to you. Like on the click of one element we are doing the action on the other element. It means that on the click of one element we are doing the action on the other element, and that is the basic purpose of the selector. Okay, if you will see the syntax, syntax clearly will tell you, like if we are going to select something to perform some action. Okay, so see here, you are going to add here some kind of ID, some kind of class or some kind of element here to perform the action on them, to perform some kind of action on them. Like in the last video we have seen here, on the click of this ID, on the click of this ID we are hiding this div ID. Okay, see, on the click of this button ID we are hiding the element of the div ID, we are hiding this div completely. So on the click of this this element, okay, this is the one element and this is the another element. Okay, here you can see here that on the click of this element, this is the action, this is our action. On the click of this element, this is our selector. Okay, on the click of this ID we are performing the action here. See, click action is here, and after that what we are doing, we are doing the another statement is there, that what we are going to do. See here, here you will see there are two kind of things are means happening here. This is the one syntax of jQuery and this is the another syntax of jQuery. Okay, here you will see that both the syntax are doing some kind of action. Okay, so here also we are using the selector, and here also we are using the selector, and in both cases we are using the ID selector. Okay, here also ID, here also ID, and on the click of here we are using action is click, and here the action is hide. Okay, so I hope that this thing is clear to you, that on the click of this element we are hiding this element, we are hiding this element. So this is the basic purpose of the selector, to do some kind of activity on HTML elements, to change the HTML elements, to perform some kind of action on HTML elements. Okay, so this is the basic purpose of the selector as the name suggests. Okay, so let's come back to the second part. Okay, so we are going to work on the three basic selectors in this video, and one is the element selector, second one is the ID selector, and third one is the class selector. Okay, so what is the element selector? Element selector means all kind of tags will come inside element selector. Like this div is the element selector, button is the element selector. Like here we are not giving this ID, we are just giving, we can give here div also, like this. Now what we are doing now, now we are hiding with the element selector. So this is the basic role of the element selector. I will show you with example here. Okay, so I am going to save this document jQuery 2 and will show you with the example. Okay, so three things we are going to do in this video: element selector, ID selector, class selector. So first of all, we are going to study the element selector, what is the basic role of the element selector and how we can use it in jQuery. Okay, so okay, so now see here what I am going to do. See, one div is already there. I will just save the file and will try to run here jQuery 2. Okay, so here you can see welcome to jQuery is here. Okay, like we have done in the last video. Now I am going to add some more divs here, simple divs I am going to add, like this is the test div 1 and few more. Okay, this is the test div 2, this is the test div 3, this is the test div 4. I hope that screen is visible to you. Okay, now see here, so we have all the divs are here. One is the earlier div and after that 1 2 3 4. Okay, now on the click of this hide button, you want to hide all the divs together. Okay, now if you will give the ID, if you will give the class, then you need to give it again and again, but you want to hide all the divs. So it is very simple to hide. Just give here div. Okay, div is the element, just give the div tag here. Okay, so this is the element, we are talking about the element. Okay, so just give the div tag here, and now I'm going to refresh and we'll click on hide, and you can see all the divs can hide together. Okay, all the divs are hide together here. So this is the first thing that we are talking about, and that is the element selector. We are now using the element selector. We are just giving the tag name here to hide all. Okay, so suppose if there are some of the tag in p tag. Okay, I am going to pick, like this is the test p tag, para tag. Okay, so see here, this is the test paragraph 1. Okay, so now it is coming like this, and one more I will give, 2. Okay, so now see, now if you want to hide one from this div, some of the divs like 2 and 3 div, and one para also. Now in this case you can do this one with the help of class. Okay, now now's the time that you can use the class. Okay, so now what we will do, we will give some kind of class, like here I'm going to give the class hide div, like we are giving or something hide sentence or hide para, yeah, or hide test. You can give hide test. Okay, hide test class, and this class I'm going to give to 2 here, 3, and once more here we are going to hide para 1 also. So now in this case, we want to hide the multiple tags. We don't want to hide all the divs. We want to hide a few of the divs and few of the paras. In this case, class is the best for us. Okay, I have just given the hide test class, and now I will just give class. Class we just represent with the dot. Okay, this is the class. Okay, whenever you will take the class as element, you just need to give the dot. Okay, and after that hide test. Okay, so now only these three, wherever you have given the classes, are going to hide. Those elements are going to hide. Okay, those tags are going to hide. So I'm going to refresh, and here hide. See here, div 2 is gone away, div 3 is gone away, para 1 is gone away. So for now, I think that this is much clear to you. So anytime if you want to hide few of the HTML elements, not all the HTML elements, and those HTML elements are means differs from one another, like some are paragraph, some are h1 tags, some are div tags, some are span tags, at that time you can use the class, jQuery class. Okay, selector, class selector you can use at that time. Okay, so this is the purpose of the class selector, when you can use to hide the multiple elements. Okay, now we will come to the ID selector. ID, okay, hash. That ID selector we are going to do with the hash. Okay, so now see if you are using the hash, then you can't use like this. See, ID will be one in one page, you can use it once only, so you can't do like this ID hide test, hide ID, this is wrong. Okay, so ID, if you are using the ID, then ID must be one. See, one particular thing you can hide with one ID, otherwise you need to do like this. So see here, like I have shown you hide, now you need to do like this hide text 2 here, hide test 3 here, hide text means here para p1. Okay, like this, then you need to do like this, you need to hide all the IDs. You need to mention here like this hide test 2, but that will not, that is you need to write too much code for this one, that is not good at all. This will work, but this is not good at all. See here, now if you are going to hide, it will work. Okay, it is working, but you need to do like this. So hide, always use ID if you are going to make change at one place. You are going to make change with one element only, with one element, then you can use the hide text ID. Okay, like see here, just I am going to give the hide test, and you just want to hide one div only. Here just you want to hide this test div 2. So at that time, see, just you just want to hide this one and no other chain. So at that time this one is perfect. Okay, so ID uniquely identifies the HTML element, so it must be one ID in one page. Never give two IDs in one page. Like if you have given the ID here, and if you have also given the ID to here, so it can create issue. Okay, so now we can try running. I am not sure that it will run. It can create the jQuery issue as well. You can check in your console. Okay, so I am going to use the ID here. See, it is see, you can see here I have given the ID to 2 and 3, and only one is working. See, only 2 is hiding, 3 is not hiding at all, because it is working on the first element, it is not working on the second element. It just work on this one and it finish its role at all, so it will not serve your purpose. Okay, so ID you can only give once, only then it will work, otherwise it will work for the first one, after that it will not work at all. okay. So if you want to hide the multiple elements, then you can go with the class, okay. And if you want to hide all the divs together, means the similar like all the divs together or all the p tags together, then the best option is to hide the element itself, like I have shown you. Like to hide the div, you just need to give here the div, okay. And to hide the p tag, you can give the p tag, okay. So like to hide all the divs together, all the divs are hide. And if you want to hide all the p tags together, you just need to give here the p tag, okay. This is here, see, everything is hide away, okay. So so I hope that now this is much clear to you, that how to use the IDs, how to use the classes, how to use the element, okay. So these three things are the most common selectors of jQuery, that you have to do some kind of experiment with them. So in next video we are going to learn about some more selectors, some advanced selectors we are going to learn, okay. So stay tuned for the next video. That's all for now. Have a nice time. Goodbye.